you all present here. On this auspicious and ever so delightful morning of the annual concert 2023, I, Shivam Shukla, along with my co-host
Tanya Barik from Grade 9,
welcome you all on behalf of the entire team of Avalon Bird School, Vaghodia. Music gives soul to the universe, wings to the mind, fly to the imagination, and charm and gaiety to life. To begin this auspicious event, here comes the school choir with the welcome song.
दियों का प्रज्वलन भी निराला है, इसके प्रज्वलन ने अंधेरे को मिटा डाला है, इसकी जगमगाहट ने वातावरण को शुद्ध बनाया है, दुख के अंधेरे को हरकर सुख का दीपक जलाया है। आज इस शुभ अवसर पर दीप जलाना है, अतिथि के कर कमलों से दिए प्रज्वलित कर सुख समृद्धि का प्रकाश फैलाना है, बच्चों के आने वाले भविष्य को दियों के प्रकाश द्वारा सुनहरा बनाना है, हृदय हो या मंदिर, दियों का प्रकाश हर जगह फैलाना है।
उग्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
सुख समृद्धि और सफलता के देवता श्री गणेश जी को हमारा शत शत नमन।
विनाशक जन सुखदायक मंगलम
Awards. We proudly present before you Janet Jain with 90.4%, the school topper for the academic year 2021-2022. Are Kimaya Sethi, would request our school's sports coaches, Ms. Sulekha Rajput, Mr. Vijay Rawal, and Mr. Salman Pinjara to the stage.
Most awaited award which the students are eager to know, and that is the overall best house award. The runners for this category is Equality House. I call upon the house warden, Ms. Gauri Shinde, and the house captain, Tanya Parekh, to come forward and receive this award. For best house goes to Honesty House. I call upon the house warden, Mr. Manjeet Singh Raj, and the house captain, Kimaya Sadi, to come forward and receive this award.
Our esteemed chief guest to release the school magazine Unnayan, Forward and Beyond. Our principal sir and our headmistress to present a memento to our dignified chief guest, Dr. A.K. Sinha.
Thank you, sir and ma'am.
I request our honorable chief guest, Dr. A.K. Sinha, to remain on stage and share some words of inspiration with the student.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Mrs. Shakya, the principal. Mrs. Renu Singh, the headmistress. Mrs. Dipali Sheku, principal DPS Harney. Of course, we have Mr. Milin from Avalon World School, Daboi. And we have the headmistresses from Harney and, of course, DPS Vadodara. Ladies and gentlemen, what is very important when we gather here this morning? Most of us out here would have thought of just one thing, that we have paid a certain amount of money for the costume of our children, and we are going to the school to witness a dance or a drama or a musical program, and that's all. Most of us come with this intent, that our children are doing some activities, we'll take some photographs, put it on the WhatsApp for all our friends and relatives, and that's over. Remember, that is no purpose at all of this program. The photographs, you're sitting over here, and anything that you do is very, very less important compared to the larger purpose which these children will achieve. This program with larger purpose which these children will achieve. This program with you in front gives the child the opportunity to look into the audience, into the eye of the audience, and perform, say or do whatever they can. And that is the most important thing. Most of the time, our children do not succeed. The reason is they cannot look into the eyes of the people in front. And I'm sure many of you, if you are called up here, right, your legs would be shaking, your hands would be shivering if you were asked to say a few words. But these children from today, when they are here on the stage, and if every year they come even once for 10 seconds, forget a minute, an hour, each year those 10 seconds add to their personalities manifold. And sometime down the line, the same children will be standing like me or any one of us, speaking without a paper in hand, only with thoughts in mind. So I congratulate each one of you for having chosen to contribute to the making of this program, ensuring by paying for the costume that your child is participating, and more than that, being present to witness the performances. And commend your child, appreciate your child for whatever they do. Because it is very essential that the child learns appreciation and grows up with appreciation. If they will learn appreciation, if they grow up with appreciation, remember, they will learn to give it back to the society. They will give it back to their friends, their relatives, and any other social concern. It's such a proud moment that DPS, under the entire umbrella, went and ventured out to places like Waghodia and Daboi to make a school that is as good as DPS Vadodara or DPS Hardni, which is in direct contact with DPS Vadodara or DPS Hardni. Whether it is the teacher training, whether it is the syllabus, whether it is the books, whether it is the examination. So remember, parents, all of you sitting over here, may be parents of Avalon World School, Waghodia, but you are getting the quality that DPS Vadodara or DPS Hardni imparts to its students. So I congratulate each one of you, the members of the staff of the school, and above all, the students who have come together to put forth this wonderful performance. Thank you very much, with a big congratulations to each one of you.
The establishment of Avalon World School, Waghodia, in June 2016 was the long-term vision of our trustee madam, Gayatri Prakash, and our pro-vice chairman, Mr. Amit Prakash, who always believed that education is not only meant for a privileged few, but should reach each and every child living even in the remote area. Education in totality, with the combination of knowledge, personality, morality, responsibility towards society, is what the school aims at. Dear parents, we are proud to announce that as per Education World, Avalon World School, Waghodia, scored overall 8th rank among all the schools available in Vadodara. And we have received first position in Gujarat in the category Social Impact Award for the year 2022. And this has been possible due to the consistent hard work and dedication of entire teaching and non-teaching staff and the continuous support of you, dear parents. Today, after 6 years, our school is happy to have fulfilled the expectations of people, and so far Three batches of students have successfully passed out with 100% result in grade 10th board examination. In last academic session, 2021-22, our grade 10 student achievement shows as 17 students out of 20 scored more than 90% marks in different subjects. Dear parents, our Parv Patel added another feather to the crown of Avalon by being topper of the NBSC exam in school, winning rupees 1,000 cash prize. Two students, Rudra Limbachia, Sain Menon, scored first position in Kala Mahakumbh in drawing and painting competition, whereas Rajuta Dabe scored second position. During Khel Mahakumbh, Tirth Pipalia scored third position in lawn tennis tournament held at Undera. Hartik Bhati scored second position in discus throw. Arush Chaudhary scored second position in skating competition. Asmi Tiwari scored first position in slok chanting in online pinnacle inter school competition organized by Cygnus World School. Ritvi Kalyan received the Global Kids Achiever Award by Dream Catchers in public speaking. Dear parents, school believes not only in academic excellence but also inculcating strong moral values, for which we have introduced Awakening Citizen program for students of grades 6 and 7 initiated by Ramakrishna Mission and CBSE. To upgrade, as our directors are told, to upgrade, update and empower our teachers, we ensure that they attend regular training, seminars, orientation program organized by CBSE and Sahodaya and other organizations. At the end, I would like to thank all dear parents for your appreciation, for your positive feedback and your suggestions, which all.
Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, a king and queen ruled over a distant land. The queen was very kind and lovely, and all the people of the realm adored her. The only sadness in the queen's life was that she wished for a child, but did not have one. As she looked at the blood fall on the snow outside her window, it turned into a baby-like face. She was surprised and said to God, "Oh, Snow God, I wish that I had a daughter that had skin as white as snow, lips as red as blood, and hair as black as ebony." As black as ebony.
"My queen, you have given me the most precious gift ever. Please tell me what you want. I will fulfill your every wish."
"Thank you, dear. But now I don't think I can spend time with my little baby."
"Oh, dear."
"You are as white as snow. I name you Snow White. Promise me, Your Majesty, you will always take care of my daughter. And promise me that you will get married again and never be sad in life without me."
"I will always take care of her at any cost, my dear."
"Don't cry, my king. Goodbye, my love. Goodbye."
"Oh, my darling."
But most of the time, the king was busy in the kingdom working. He realized that his daughter needed a loving mother for upbringing, so he decided to marry again. The new queen was very beautiful, but more than that, she was very arrogant and a cruel woman. She had studied dark magic, and with that she controlled the king. She also owned a magic mirror that predicts and tells the truth whenever and whatever she wants to know. My dear mirror, oh mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of all?
Oh, my queen, you are the fairest of all.
Oh, really? Thank you so much. You are a genius. As the time passed by, Snow White became prettier, fairer than ever before. She became the most beautiful girl in all the kingdoms. The stepmother started to feel jealous about her beauty. Mirror, oh mirror on the wall, who's the fairest in the world?
You, my queen, are fair and beautiful, it is true. But Snow White is even fairer than you.
Oh, how dare you talk like this? You're nonsense.
Apologies. I am only made to speak the truth, my lady.
The queen flew into a rage and called her huntsman. Take that Snow White into the woods and kill her. And bring me her heart as proof.
Yes, my lady. Your stepmother ordered me to kill you. But I can't kill a beautiful and kind soul like you. Run away as far as possible and never turn back to the castle again.
Oh, kind man. My mother will punish you if you do not kill me.
I will tackle her somehow. But now, you, go!
After wandering the forest, so she lay down on one of the little beds and fell fast asleep. Meal. She barely had a bite in her mouth when she fell on the ground, dead. The wicked queen transformed into her real self. White as snow, red as blood, black as ebony wood. The seven dwarfs shall never, ever awaken you. Immediately ran back to the palace and stood in front of a broken piece of mirror. Mirror, mirror on the wall,
Who in this land is fairest of all?
The mirror finally answered as she was wishing.
You, my queen, you are the fairest of all.
Here lies the princess Snow White. Then they put the coffin outside on the mountain snow. The animals and the birds came too and mourned for Snow White. At the same time, a prince entered into the same mountain area to hunt. He saw the crowd of dwarfs and animals around the glass case. The prince wondered what in the world would be in the case that attracted so many pretty animals. The prince went near and read what was written on it with golden letters. He thought this was the same girl whom he had always dreamed of. Then he saw the dwarfs nearby.
Let me have the coffin. I will give you anything to have this pretty girl.
We will not sell it for all the gold in the world.
Please give it to me. I cannot live without being able to see her. I will die if you won't allow me to take her.
Are you crazy? What will you do with this dead body?
I will honor her and build a monument near my palace to rest her soul in peace.
The good dwarfs felt pity for him and accepted his demand. The prince had his servants carry it away on their shoulders, but then it happened. Then one of them stumbled while picking the coffin, and this dislodged the piece of poisoned apple that she had bitten off. The prince immediately ran and caught the coffin. He put her under a tree and gazed at her. She was still looking pretty, as she was alive. The prince kissed her on the forehead. As soon as he kissed Snow White, she opened her eyes. Snow White sat up and was alive again. Good heavens, where am I?
You were with me. I am a prince.
And the prince told her what had happened. Oh my God! You decided to keep me even if I was dead? But why?
You are the only girl in my dreams. I love you more than anything else in the world. Come with me to my castle. Will you marry me and be my queen?
Yes, my charming prince.
Oh, ko chupa ka hai loti to ko an chupa ka hai loti to kisna gori amba badla ko palna bandi la ko bandi na ye halila palna bandi la ko an palna bandi na ye halila palna bandi la ko
and guidance in all our events. Thank you.